Once again, it's January and the temperatures are so high as expected, at least for the recent past, and Ugandans are actually making fun about it, just how hot the temperatures are. But is it all fun and games? How serious are these temperatures and what impact are they going to have on us as human beings living here in this country? Joining me today, we have Gerald Tenua, and he is an environment reporter here with the New Vision, and he's going to dissect some of what to expect and also what we're experiencing as Ugandans. Thank you very much, Gerald, for making time to this special interview on the environment. So let's start off with the impact of the hot temperatures that we're experiencing this January in Uganda. And also, is it just something we can laugh about and move on and wait for the rains, or are we in serious danger as human beings living in this country?
Of course, the Uganda National Meteorological Authority, which is the lead agency on weather matters in Uganda, it released a report January 3rd, 2023, indicating that we are going to have very dry conditions in January and February. But then there are also occasional rains which we should expect. When you say we are going to have dry conditions, some people sometimes imagine that we are not going to have any rain at all. So when they see this rain coming once or twice in 3 days or 1 week, they keep on saying that the weatherman was wrong. No, they are right on the spot, and they are saying in southwestern Uganda and parts of central Uganda, we are going to receive some occasional rain between January and Feb. But in the northern part of this country and the northeastern, we are going to have very severe dry conditions, and people there are going to survive off with very lean pasture and very little quantities of water. Most of the seasonal water sources are likely to dry up, and even these other parts of the country, we are not going to have as much pasture as we should. Parts of the cattle corridor, that is that our whole stretch moving from northeastern Uganda, from Karamoja across central Uganda, across Lake Choga, up to Sembabule, Mubende, Tungamo, and then of course Rakai and Mbarara, we are going to have very severe dry spells.
And now, looking at Uganda as a country, once again, 70% of the population is involved in agriculture, and agriculture in Uganda has majorly relied on natural rain. We don't have a lot of irrigation going on. So I get, you know, inspired to ask a question about how we are going to make it through these hot temperatures, but also on the flip side, are they actually very important for us, or should we be worried about what this hot weather could do to our food production, being the food basket in the region?
Of course, that is one of the biggest issues in this country, because agriculture depends on natural resources. We depend directly on the rain. Agriculture is rain-fed. And of course, when you have seasons where critical resources like water are not being delivered at the right time and at the right place where people expect it, you expect challenges to happen. And this is what is likely to happen. People are likely to be to run out of water, so it is going to be a bit tricky to produce, especially when it comes to good pasture, good water resources that can support animal production. But of course, it's going to be off-season for growing of crops, and this season is going to be good for probably harvesting, and then of course post-harvesting activities where we need to dry up crops like maize and even other forms of harvest.
All right, so the fight against climate change effects is the rage right now, and the rest of the world is just, you know, awake to this, which I've also realized that Uganda is waking up, even though very slowly, to the impacts of, you know, climate change. So what would we do as a country to be able to achieve, alongside the rest of the world, what we can call reversing the impact of climate change that we've witnessed over the years?
Climate change is here with us, and it is becoming so severe because the emissions that are responsible for raising these temperatures, they are still in the atmosphere, and they are still capturing most of the heat which is escaping from the earth's surface, and this is going to impact on so many aspects of life. And then of course some of this is going to be very severe to human development, because we've also destroyed the environment, which is supposed to act as a shield against some of these changes in the climate. You have water bodies and wetlands and forests which are supposed to capture most of this water, which is actually in some cases coming in a shorter time. You have rain which should come in 1 week, it comes in a day or two. And once you don't have reservoirs that can keep this water for long, then you are likely to have floods, landslides, and this is what is happening even now.
Great. Thank you very much, Gerald, for making time to be part of this special interview tonight, and we look forward to having you again. Thank you very much for having joined us for this special interview. We had Gerald Tenua. He is an environment reporter here with the New Vision, and he is dissecting what you and I are experiencing with the changing weather conditions and what to expect ahead as we go through this hot January and the rest of the year. We shall see you next time. Back to the news.